river, we shall all.
Is this a unity fountain or not? Can you pass? Let me move.
What you see here is not a stage play, but a true reality of what played out at the Unity Fountain when members of the Bring Back Our Girls group convened to start a protest to the presidential villa. The protesters had hardly filed out of the Unity Fountain before they were barricaded by men of the Nigeria Police Force, leading to traffic congestion on the highway. For over 1.5 hours, the drama continued. The co-convener of the group speaks against the intimidation.
Today we gathered to do our usual march, and the Nigerian police has refused for us to leave the Unity Fountain. Some of our colleagues have already gone, and they are going to be giving their press statement there. Those of us that they have locked in here, in particular, they have refused that I should move. They have built a human prison and have violated my fundamental right to freedom of movement and association. And therefore, I want it to be on record that the government of President Muhammadu Buhari has infringed the constitution by violating my fundamental right to freedom of movement and association.
Before the barricade, members of the group explained the reason for the protest at the presidential villa.
Today's 1,380 days. We want 112 of our Chibok girls to be back. We also have three lecturers of the University of Maiduguri who were abducted. They're in captivity too, and then we have more than 14 Lhasa women who were on their way to bury a fallen police officer and were abducted too.
We have a lot of security concerns. We have our girls who are still abducted. We have the UNIMED lecturers who have not been accounted for. They're still in captivity. We have the Lhasa women who are in captivity, as well as thousands of other people in captivity. Let's not also forget the people of the Benue and the Taraba, this herdsmen crisis. So it's the federal government really has to stand up to its responsibility.
And then finally, members of the movement leave the Unity Fountain to meet up with other members of the group who had been at the villa gate. Here, seven members of the group were arrested, and after a long drive around the city of Abuja, they were taken to the FCT command of the Nigeria Police. Some members of the group followed them to the FCT police command to demand their release. They were subsequently released after several hours. However, the group insists that they remain resolute in their demands for the safe return of the 102 girls still in the stronghold of their abductors 1,380 days after their abduction.